A moment after she started walking, her face hardened, she looked down, as if she was thinking intently about something. I held her hand and guided her, since she wasn't looking where she was going. She was silent for a moment, and then she looked up at me. There wasn't the slightest hint of cheer in her face. No, it was a cell phone.
I said it was a cell phone.
You don't even have to be... You literally don't have to know anything about electronics to be like, hey, this isn't a cell phone. Common knowledge will tell you it's not a cell phone. What are these electrical prongs? Nah, that's a cell phone. No shit. Oh hey, how's it going? Just as expected, we couldn't pass through the gate like normal. There were several teachers searching the bags and pockets of all the students coming into the school. Somehow, I don't think they'd let you through with the stab-proof vest either, just going out there, but sure. Yeah, they'll confiscate a ruler. You chuck it over the wall. As expected, the teachers all tensed up as we approached the school gate. Several of them looked at each other, and then they took me and Kimika aside to search us. Why is a male teacher searching her? What? Opened my bag, showed them the insides, then turned my pockets inside out. I didn't have anything in them. I got through the gate surprisingly easy. The real problem was Kimika, who was surrounded by several teachers. It's hard to imagine that she could come to school empty-handed after the fight with Akasaka and Kitami yesterday. She said she saw this coming, but will she really be okay? If they're actually serious about this policy, they would, but they probably won't. It's like they're aiming for her from the beginning. They seem disappointed since they hadn't found evidence. Yeah, I wonder why they're aiming for her. It's like she's the reason this policy was started. Thankfully, she was released. She smiled and ran towards me. She mouthed the words, fooled them, silently announcing her victory. No, it just means they weren't doing their job effectively. Kimika frowned and looked at the school building, and I followed her gaze. In the spot where Kimika was looking, Akasaka and Kitami were looking down at us from above. Their eyes were cold and ruthless, but their mouths were curved in a disgusting smile. They were anticipating the festivities that were about to start. But I glared right back at them. I won't give in to them. I'll fight.
Expressed
too many emotions in the last other chapter sign. Kimika smiled joyfully. The moment we entered the classroom, it instantly went from noisy to silent as a grave, and sharp gazes were leveled at us. Much worse than yesterday, it felt incredibly uncomfortable. The classroom wasn't just a metaphorical battlefield. It transformed into a literal one after yesterday's events. so it'd be a lie to say I wasn't affected, but nevertheless, I walked toward my seat unflinchingly. I was about to pull my chair out and sit down. Kimika stopped me and started checking the desk and the chair. After she made sure my seat was safe to sit in, she checked her own seat and then sat down.
ねえねえ、みんな、ちょっと変な匂いがしなくね？本当だ。マジくせえわ。ああ、くせくせ。どこから匂ってくるのかな？どこかな、どこかな。臭いものには蓋をしなくちゃな。
The other students were frozen like statues. Megu and Satoko exaggeratedly held their noses as they walked around the
classroom.
I wonder. They held their noses like pigs and walked around. Then, as if they were planning it from the beginning, they moved toward our desks. No shit, it's planned. Kimika's relaxed voice echoed in the strained atmosphere of the classroom. Kimika smiled as she stood up, pulled a test tube out from her bag. In that instant, they stopped in their tracks. There wasn't any smell coming from the test tube at all, of course not. They were just making it all up. Their faces grew paler and paler by the moment.
そうなんだろうね。すでに白山から聞いてるんじゃないの？もしかするとそれって。ご明察。さすがは彼女だけあって、彼氏の体臭には敏感なようですね。
Megu looked like she was about to jump on Kimika, but she didn't. She kept her distance since she knew what was inside the test tube.
いやいや、申し訳ない。これの匂いは実際かなりきついから。昨夜は彼氏と抱き合ってキスすることもできなかったでしょうね。ごめんね。今頃彼氏は欲求不満でイライラしまくっているのかな。うん、怖い怖い。
I mean, if I was you, I wouldn't want him angry. Because he'll take it out on you, but you do you, I guess.
調子に乗ってんじゃ。やめなよ、サトコ。あれを食らったらマジ悲惨だからさ。
She can get on it. I don't care. After Megu told her to stop, Satoko didn't dare getting close to Kimika. She just stood next to Megu looking disgusted.
肛門で一斉持ち物検査してたのに。なんで持ち込めてるんだよ。
Because you can just bring random test tube vials into school, apparently. She's actually part of the chemistry club. Or something like that. Oh, that's right. I haven't ever heard of the club doing anything, so I forgot, but Kimika's in two clubs. I never knew she was the leader of it, though. Oh, that's convenient.
タンパク質を脱炭酸反応、脱アミノ反応、還元したものが持ち物検査で引っかかると思う？
Then there's really no reason why you'd bring it with you back and forth between school. The two then glared at her vehemently as they stood there.
さて、ここにも持ち物検査をパスした物があります。見た目は 布製品などに使う消臭スプレーの除菌プラスにしか見えません。
It's really acid. Actually, no, it's probably gonna be pepper spray, right?
まあ、持ち運びは簡単だし、噴霧口がオンオフ切り替えになっており、内容…でも、例えばさ、これの内容物が強アルカリ性の水酸化ナトリウムだった場合、
水酸化ナトリウム？
You know, the normal stuff.
うん、基本的に水酸化ナトリウムはプラスチック製容器に密閉して保存。それは固体でも溶液でも同じなんだな。つまりこの消臭スプレーの容器に水酸化ナトリウムを入れることは可能なわけよ。
それがどうしたんだよ。
さて、この水酸化ナトリウムをもし噴霧した場合、どん大事な指輪とかネックレスとかに噴霧した場合、金属製品は簡単に腐食してしまいます。
That's it.
でも本当に大変なのは人間に対して噴霧した場合でして。
どうなるんだよ。
Mega's voice cracked as she looked, asked the question, the smile disappearing from Kimika's face. Yeah, I don't think it's wise to try to hurt someone, because again, they can turn it on you and get you arrested.
まずは上履きなんかに噴霧した場合、気がつかずに履いた人は初期段階ではぬるぬるとした感触を感じるでしょう。それは次第に痒みに変わり、そしてその後激痛となる。これは水酸化ナトリウムにより溶解した角質が初期段階ではぬるぬると感じるものであり、最終的には痛覚に届くくらい皮膚を溶解し、次は単純に顔に噴霧した場合、角膜上皮に付着した場合、適切な処置が遅れると十分に失明の可能性があります。まあ要するにこいつが付着すると肌の細胞がドロドロベチョベチョのグッチョンになるわけです。
Yeah, you can't really say that it's justifiable self-defense to use that. You can with like a stun gun, pepper spray, a baton even. You can't say, oh yeah, I use some acid to dissolve that person's skin. It's self-defense though. Yeah, that's not gonna fly. She happily threatened them with her explanation. The two of them couldn't say a word. I just think it's a really, really not wise to use. But...can do whatever she wants. When I looked around, I didn't feel the same pressure from the rest of the class either. None of them liked Megu or Satoko either, so they were all as silently snickering as they watched. Kimika took another test tube from her bag. It was different from the others. There was a partition in the middle for some reason, with mysterious white powder on both sides of the partition. Some explosive?
この2つの粉、なんで2つに分けられていると思いますか？
なんだよ。二つの粉が混ざったらまずいと。
まずいものね。二種類の物質が混ざっただけで危険なものってそんなに簡単に手に入るかな。
Yeah, it's really easy. Really easy. After that, she chuckled to herself so silently that it was almost audible. I mean, you can make...Some really bad gases just by buying two household cleaning equipment.
Oh, でも、例えば、次亜塩素酸カルシウム。あ、わかりやすく言うと、さらし粉のことですね。これは、プールの水を消毒するためなどに、普通に学校で転がっているレベルだな。それに、塩化アンモニウムか。つい最近まで普通に買えたんだけど、今は免許なしだと買えないのか。でも最近まで売ってたから、まあ持っている人もいるかもね。塩化アンモニウムは肥料、食品添加物、染色、用途はたくさんあるから持っている人はいるかも。あ、そうそう、火薬の原料でもあるんだな、これ。次亜塩素酸カルシウムと混合させると、 非常に不安定な物質となり、少しの衝撃で
ドカーン。
まあスタンガンとは比べ物にならないだろうな。なんたってその2つの粉の混合体は一般に火薬と言われてるものなんですからな。
Of course it is。
そうだ、他に塩化カリウムも入手が比較的楽かな。これにバッテリーを煮詰めて作った硫酸を混合すると、
Boil batteries?
あー、これまた不思議なことに大爆発するんだな。
You're part of a science club and there's probably sulfuric acid in the school, but no, I'm just gonna boil batteries instead.
そんなもの学校に持ってきてるのか、お前。
え？持ってきてませんよ。ただ混ぜると危険な物質の話をしてるだけだし。
They can still turn this on her though. That, it's not a wise play, but... Whatever, whatever.
よろしければ試してみます？これ投げつけると、
sure.
瓶の中身は混ざって、
throw it at the table. Throw it at the wall over there.Here, test her. Throw it against the wall. Fuck it. Really test it. As Kimika's voice grew more and more ominous, Megu's face, caked with makeup, tightened into an ugly frown. The classroom went silent.
そういう意味ではまあ想定内ですな。
You're done now? All eyes were on the vial in Kimika's hand. If it really is an explosive, that means everyone in this room is in danger. A brusque voice ripped through the silence.
おら、立花いるか。
あらら、もう登場かよ。
翼。
A male student that hardly ever shows up in the classroom suddenly burst in and frothing in rage. Even his girlfriend Megu was visibly afraid of him.
てめえ、昨日のことを忘れたとは言わねえだろうな。
何言ってるんですか。忘れやしませんよ。私にとっては低層の危機だったんですからね。
The other students, who were trying to ignore the tussle before, all gulped in unison as they saw Shiroyama, but Kimika didn't flinch. Yeah, I'm walking out the classroom now. Because he's gonna do something.
女だからって甘くしてりゃいい気になりやがって。てめえ、血を吐くまで謝罪させてやる。
You know, I don't think anyone thinks you won't hit a girl. Because I'm pretty sure you do. All of them. His eyes lit up with anger. He looked like he was about to punch her.
男が女に優しくするのは当然ですよ。ジェントルマンじゃありませんな。白山、それよりこれ新作なんだけど、一つ試してみる？結構刺激的だよ。
Kimika held the tube with the divider in it up to eye level, waved it back and forth in front of him, challenging him to do something.
だからなんだってんだ。昨日は不意をつかれただけで、また当たると思うなよ。
Shiroyama flipped over a desk to intimidate Kimika, completely ignoring the person sitting in it. At it. Kimika just smiled. She picked up. What the hell?
何吠えてるんだよ。吠えるぐらいなら殴りかかってくればいいじゃん。
Hit her with the desk.
何机に当たってんのさ。ダサ。
てめえ！
ちょ、待てよ、翼！
邪魔すんなよ、こら！こいつの顎を割らなきゃ気が済まねえんだよ！
分かってる！分かってるから！
Shiroyama brushed Megu and kicked another desk over.
こいつのせいで、俺が昨日どんだけひでえ目にあったか、お前だって知ってるだろ！
I smelled bad.
そうかもしれない。でも、今は我慢しろよ！
He struggled with her, almost looking like he was about to hit her too, but she managed to hold him back.Again, I wouldn't be surprised if he has hit her.
あの試験官、昨日のとは違うんだってば。
黙れ、そんなの関係ねえ。
関係あるよ。あれが割れると爆発するかもしれねえんだって。
Again, I really doubt it if she's holding it that close to herself. And if he's right next to her, she's not gonna throw it at him when
he's literally right next to her. It'd be kind of stupid.
そしたら昨日程度じゃ済まなくなるよ。あんたそれでもいいの？シャツに穴が開くだけじゃ済まないかもよ。
あんだと。
When she told him that, the tension in his body slowly faded, though the look of malice never left his face.
立花を見なよ。これだけ脅しをかけてるのに全然平気じゃないか。嘘っぱちな代物なら、こうも余裕かます根拠にならないって。
She was serious. There's no way she'd let you get close to her for her to use it because it would blow her up.
あんたの体も心配だけど、もし教室内で爆発したら、下手すると警察沙汰じゃん。そうなるといくら私でもかばいきれないよ。ちゃんと分かってんの？
Yeah, she'd get arrested. She made the explosion. You can't. It's not self-defense. You can't blow someone up. What? Yeah, it's your fault because she threatened to blow you up. So you wanted to attack her, and she blew you up. If the police were called, it would be a blemish on her records as well.But it would be worse for Shirayama since he had been arrested several times before. I think if he blew up, he'd have something else to worry about rather than being arrested. He hadn't given it up, given in. But he had no choice but to stand his ground and stare menacingly at Kimika once Megu let him go. Kimika, one of the smallest people in the room, stood in the center of the tense classroom and giggled.
Baka, baka.
No.
いいからとりあえずもうホームルーム始まるからさ教室から出た方がいいって
けどあの女
後で何とでもなるだろここで暴れたらあんたの方がまずい立場になるっての
ちしょう俺をここまでコケにしやがって覚えてろよクソが絶対殺してやるからな
That's niceHe left without doing what he came for. It was a huge relief to see him sulk off, into the hallway, muttering complaints to himself. Kimika's laughter echoed in the silent classroom. Everyone was afraid of the person who, until recently, had been the weakest person in the room.
So, Martin Luther was...強大な権力に真っ向から立ち向かった宗教改革者であり。
I was able to participate in class normally since I had copied Kimika's textbook yesterday, but Megu glared daggers at us throughout the entire class.
彼は多くの賛美歌を作り、ラテン語で記されていた新約聖書をドイツ語に訳すなどの功績も残した。
But Kimika didn't even seem to notice. She just paid attention to class, highlighting important parts in her textbook. No matter what happens, don't let them get to you.Okay. Even if it's just acting, you can't show them weakness. Kimika told me that over and over while we were on our way to school, but I can't stay calm like her. She really is amazing. When morning classes ended, Megu and Satsuki left the classroom. The other students started moving their desks together to eat with their friends. And of course, I probably wouldn't even need to say it, but they all turned their backs toward us and ignored us as they ate. Kimika moved her desk over next to mine.
なんとか午前中はクリアだね。
そうだね。
しかし、あれだけ楽しい見せ物だったのに、相変わらず人気なクラスだね。
しょうがないよ。みんな赤坂さんとか白山くんとかのこと怖いし。
だから我関せずか。まったく、気概がない連中だ。
They're not cowards. Not everyone can be strong as you, Kimika.Not everyone has so many weapons to defend themselves from violence.
ね、せっかくだから、他の場所でお弁当にしない？
うん、まあそれもいいかもね。キモい連中もなんだか私のこと睨んでるし。
Yeah, it's like you said you have a bunch of weapons and chemicals on you. Wonder why they're staring at you.
だと？
何？
やめなよ、サトコ。
キミカ。
ごめんごめん。今のはさすがにいらない挑発だったよね。んじゃあ、行こうか。
キミカ smiled agreeably and then moved her desk back to its original position with her skinny arms.
で、どこに行こうか。
I can only guess where she wants to go and hopes to find someone.
他に誰もいなくて、どこまでも開放的で。
I mean, it just so happens to be the same place Mommy always is, but you know.
グラウンド？
あ、いや、屋上に行こうかなって。
At least she's not transparent.
あ、そうか、屋上か。私はザクラがいいっていう場所ならどこでもいいよ。
Okay, that's kind of weird, but whatever.
何それ？変な君か。
You do you.
でも君かがいいのなら屋上へ行こうよ。
I smiled at her and nodded. We went to the vending machine to buy some milk first, then headed to the rooftop. The building a rooftop gets way hotter during the day than before. Then I thought.
これダメじゃない？ザクロ、ここにいると女性との干物が二つできるだけだわ。
うん。だから誰も来ないんだよ。
知ってたのかよ。
いいからいいから。とりあえず行こう。
行く？あ、どこに？
Go where Mamiya is.
そっか。ビート屋上はこんな涼しい
の。 That's the entire reason she's up here.
日差しと風の関係。それでここはこんなに涼しいんだってさ。
またお前か。
すみません。
Oh wow, what a coincidence. I didn't know you'd be here. Mommy frowned when he saw me, and then he shook his head back and forth like he was denying something. Oh, hey, delinquent, Takuji.
あんたなんでここにいるの？
Interesting that you're here.
それは俺のセリフだ。なんでお前らがここにいる？
Why isn't Yuki here?
あ、あのね。ごめん。私たちにもここ使わせてくれないかな。
Yeah, this is my roof. You're not allowed to be on this roof. What the fuck? Of course you can be here.
で、そっちのは？あれが人に物を頼む態度なのか？
ここは私とザクロが使うの。今すぐ出て行きなさい。
Literally here first, so fuck off.
なんで俺が出て行かなきゃいけない？
そうね。だったらどいてもらおうかしら。
Try.
この前のお礼もしてないし。
またいろいろと仕込んでるみたいだな。
うん。あんた相手にするのに警棒とか催涙スプレーじゃ全然ダメだって分かったから。
君か。あのマミヤ君ごめんなさい。
なんでザクロが謝るのよ。
I don't know. Maybe because you're threatening to beat him for no reason.
あ、いや。あのね、常識的に今謝るのは私たちの方だから。
We? Her.
ザクロはそうやってすぐこいつに騙される。
You can't beat someone with a baton for lying. You may want to, but you still can't.
ここは誰の場所でもない。痛いのならいればいい。俺と喧嘩したいのならいくらでも買ってやる。
言ったわね。
Yeah, Kimika, you're gonna get your ass kicked.
Kimika! 謝って。悪いのは君か。謝りなさい。
そんな。
マミヤ君ごめんなさい。ほら君か。
なんでそうなるんだよ。私はザクロのことを思って。
You weren't accomplishing anything. Kimika looked like she was about to cry. Why? And she looked so strong when she was arguing with Megu and Satsuko just a moment ago too.
そんなにそいつがいいのか。
Yeah, she'd probably kill 8 children for him.
え？
ザクロは私よりそいつを選ぶのか。
She would push you off a roof to be with him. 100%.
あの、君か。
ああ、私だってこんな頑張ってるのに。
She's so obsessed with him.
うるさくてかなわ。
Like, it's not even a competition. No one, like, even comes close.
Yeah,
勝負したいならお前から手を出せばいい。貴様ごとき素人に遅れを取るような俺じゃない。
にゃんだと生意気だ。
Pretty sure he's taller than you.
ダメ何そんな危険物を。それさっき爆発するって言ってたやつじゃない。止めるな、ザクロ。私はこいつを殺す。
お前さ、そういう物腰だからあんな胸小さいんじゃねえの。
なんですと。
そっちの高島みたいに少しは女の子らしく振る舞えば父も大きくなるんじゃないのかって言ってるんだよ。そんな汚い言葉ばかり使ってるから女性ホルモンが少なくて胸がなくなるんだよ。
Wow, you got a scientific study for that。
なんだそのオカルト、この文系能が。んな学説どこにあるんだよ。ソース示せ、データ示せ、参考論文示せ。
あのね、君か、落ち着こうよ。
だってザクロが。
I gently embrace Kimika. When she gets worked up like this, she looks like a little puppy. So I wondered if she would calm down if I hugged her just like I would with puppies.
ザクロ大丈夫だよ。キミカよりマミヤ君が大事とかそういうのないから。
いや、No one said it doesn't mean it's not true。
なら私の方が好きってこと？
No。
いや、そういう問題ではなく。
If we get an answer, we already know who's more important。
なんだお前ら。こんな場所でコントの練習か。卒業後はそれで食っていく気か。
Like, just because I don't list favorite girls doesn't mean I don't have one.
で、あんたみたいなばかりそんなこと言われなきゃいけないのよ。
Wow.
私は一流大学行くわい。そんで将来はマッドサイエンティストだ。それがダメならニートだ。
I wish I could be a neat.
それもバカな夢だな。
だとマッドサイエンティストばかりするか。
Maybe because it's unrealistic.
ニートはダメだろう。
If you can actually not have to worry about money, I would prefer that.
ニートばかりすんな。
Yeah, but I really wouldn't want to be one, to be honest.
もう、キミカ。
I like working.
ご飯食べようよ。
Unfortunate.
こんなことやってたら昼休み終わっちゃうよ。
I also like conversating.With people, or conversing with people.
そう言われてみれば、ない。
そうか。それは良かったな。
Postpone your execution. Wow.